ඔන්නකේ විෂන් කෑකට ගියානම් ඉවරයිනේ
විෂන් කෑ විශ්වාසනීය දැක්ම
regions have harvested the fruits of peace and peaceful conflict resolution. Unfortunately, the South Asian region has lagged behind. But unfortunately, this region, which houses 1.5 billion people and with the fastest growth rate in our region, I'm sure in next 25 years, this is going to be the largest bloc in the world. What are we looking at? Are we looking at more hunger? Are we looking at more poverty, internal wars, interstate wars? Well, that's one side of the story. The other side is regional cooperation, the economic progress, the prosperity, the peace. Choice has to be made. As speakers have said, the SAARC has not failed. I'm not saying for the sake of demagoguery. Because there has never been a problem on the people level. People don't want to fight. There are few, okay, let's call them leaders. Let's call them whatever, politicians, not the statesmen. For their own vested interests, the conflict is propelled artificially. And then there is the economics. Economy of conflict. SAARC can be effective, and I assure it will be. It is just a matter of time. We need better leadership, and when we have that leadership, the SAARC will become effective and peace will prevail in this region. The fact of the matter is that Kashmir is a dispute between the biggest members of the SAARC. And if this issue is not resolved, there will be no sustainable peace in South Asia. If an organization needs to be restructured, it must be done. If needs a new
Speaking further, the Pakistani High Commissioner said projects such as the Belt and Road Initiative will hand Sri Lanka great opportunities to expand on trade and commerce.
There are new realities which are emerging. The BRI, that has been mentioned, CPEC. So a lot is being said about Sri Lanka, about the BRI, about Pakistan, the CPEC. But the fact remains that it is opening many vistas of regional cooperation, of regional integration, regional connectivity, and economic benefit and economic cooperation. The Sri Lanka, last but not the least, will have great opportunities to do commerce and trade with Central Asia. So vice versa, the Central Asian states will be in a position to do a lot of commerce and trade with Sri Lanka, and then going toward south with ASEAN.